Greetings, I am Herbert Erpaderp, and today I'm going to build this Zvezda BA-10. This is, as you can probably see, the 1/100th or 15mm scale snap kit from Zvezda. The back of the box looks pretty much how I would expect it to. It tells us the model is 4.5cm long, which is about 2 inches if you happen to use freedom units. Also, the model is made up of 25 parts, which does seem like quite a few for a Zvezda kit. There are also 3 images of the assembled, but not painted, model. This looks good, though the flag does kind of make it look a bit weird. That's okay, it's not something you're forced to add. Inside the box we find this bit of paper. It talks about Zvezda's game Art of Tactic, and the instructions also start on the first page, which is a bit unusual, I suppose, but probably has something to do with the parts count. On the other side we see the rest of the instructions. These aren't overly complex or anything, though I was still able to make things hard for myself by not properly understanding them. You'll see that later. It would be pretty bad if the only thing in the box was a bit of paper. Fortunately, there's also a sprue. This contains all the bits you'll need to make one BA-10. There's no extra or optional parts, but that's okay. Everything here looks pretty neat and tidy. This is a more recent Zvezda kit, so this isn't surprising. The older ones are okay too, though they might need a bit more cleanup, and the newer ones do tend to have a few more parts. The detailing is pretty nice. It's not super detailed or anything like that, but it is cheap and a gaming piece, so you should set your expectations accordingly. I think the turret is pretty good, especially for a single piece. It's pretty well detailed. Very good, let's put it together. The first part is these mudguards, which kind of look like they're on a sprue, but this is in fact the framey, spiny bit of the vehicle, so don't clip the central parts off. The first step is to connect the front side parts, I guess is a suitable name to call them. These are pressed into place on either side. It's slightly fiddly to get them in past the rear wheel guards, but with a bit of fiddling you can get there. I ummed and ahed about leaving these unglued. It is a snap kit and you don't need glue, but I do like to have everything stay nicely in place, so I use glue, and I glued these parts on. I kind of feel like that was a bit of a mistake, but a bigger mistake was not installing the bottom frame part at this point. That is what the instructions said to do, but I was probably not paying enough attention. Moving on, I installed the spare wheels next. There's a peg on either side towards the front for these, and they're not at all hard to install. Next, I glue the 2 upper hull parts together. This is pretty simple. They won't stay together with friction until installed on the hull, though glue makes that irrelevant. I then attached those upper hull parts and found them to be quite gappy, and I was kind of surprised by this, and a little bit disappointed. I spent some time applying pressure to deal with those gaps as best I could, but the result isn't that good. It's not super terrible and it could be fixed quite easily with some putty, but it's still a bit disappointing. I feel like this might have been caused by not installing the frame when it should have been installed, which is what I tried to do next. I have obviously edited out a lot of this, but I had a quite frustrating and annoying experience in trying to get this into place. It's not the kit's fault though, it's entirely mine for not reading the instructions properly. This required a lot of force and bending of bits, and maybe a couple of slightly annoyed words, like fiddlesticks. You can see there's a couple of stress marks in the plastic, which is not ideal, but it could be worse. Fortunately, I got it together in the end, probably almost exactly how it should be. I do kind of like how there's a notch in the front mudguards for the spare tires. Next come the headlamps. These are pretty cool. They're mounted on bars which are fairly thin, which does make it a bit fiddly to install without breaking, and of course tweezers were very helpful. It ends up looking pretty good though in my opinion. This is some quite fine detail, especially in this scale from Zvezda. It gets a hearty thumbs up from me. You can't see me but I've done the thumbs up. Then it's time for the forward axle set. I didn't press this in far enough and I didn't realise until later. I had pressed it in about as far as I could without breaking the suspension-y bits, but I guess the fit was just a bit tighter than I had expected. I then added the front wheels. You do have to apply a little pressure to get these to go on all the way. The wheels are noticeably too low when they're in place, especially if you look from the front. It's also worth noting that there's no front bumper on this kit, even though the image on the front of the box shows the vehicle with a bumper. I know the part isn't missing because it's not depicted on the model on the back of the box. I left it be and saw to the rear wheels. First comes this little bar thing. You'll notice that this suspension is surprisingly detailed for a Zvezda 15mm scale kit, not that I'm complaining. The next part is the axles part. The pins for this are different sizes, so it should really only go on one way. Quite suspension-y if you ask me. It makes sense to add the wheels next. There are two wheels per axle here, and it pays to pay attention to the instructions to be sure which one you're installing. As you can see, I've got the inner wheels on, and these should be facing the same way as the forward ones. The outer wheels go on the opposite way, with the hub more towards the body of the vehicle. That makes sense, right? At some point, I press the front wheels up even further, damaging the suspension in the process. It would still look a bit better with a front bumper, but there wasn't one included. I checked. Then the turret can be pressed into place. There's no need to glue this, the friction holds it quite tightly. In fact, I had trouble removing it after test fitting. At any rate, the 15mm scale BA-10 by Zvezda is now complete and ready to do BA-10 things, which I presume to be sick jumps. Okay, so this isn't the most perfect model, but I'm still fairly happy with how it's turned out, especially considering that it may have ended up half-built through my own incompetence. The gaps along the cab and engine compartment aren't as bad as they could have been, but they're still there and can definitely use some filling. That's okay, filling gaps is kind of part of the hobby. Well, I mean, you don't have to fill them, but you know what I mean. Hopefully, me showing you the wrong way to put this kit together is helpful. If you can learn from my mistakes, then my making them is not so bad. Also, I guess it would benefit me if I were planning to make more of these. I'm not, but you never know. I may find a need for a whole bunch of these, and then I'll know what not to do. And I'll say, gee, thanks, Past Herbert, you were a real bro. I would imagine if you put this thing together in the correct order, it's a much more pleasant and likely a lot quicker build. This was finished in a single stream, but it did take a bit longer than I had expected. Mistakes aside, the result is pretty reasonable, especially considering that this kit is quite cheap. It'll represent a BA-10 on the gaming table quite nicely, and in the end, that's really what matters for this kind of model. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the comments section below. I hear that's what it's for. If you want to watch me build models like this, mistakes and all, live on stream, go to twitch.tv/Herbert_Erpaderp or follow the convenient link below. If you haven't done so already, why not subscribe, follow, ring the bell, become a patron or YouTube member, or just come say hi on Twitch or Discord. And if you're feeling really helpful, why not share this video with your friends or anybody you think might get something out of it? There are links to all of my things in the description below. And, as always, I shall return soon. So, until then, be excellent to each other, and thanks for watching. Farewell.